Good morning, and welcome to Church of the Holy Spirit. And to all of our mothers, happy Mother's Day. Today we celebrate with our presider, Father John Hoffman. Our lector is Linda Engel. Our soloist is Sarah Murray. Our guitarist is Kevin Gallagher. Our videographer is Maria Borla. And on piano, I'm Tom Phelan. And wherever we are today, in the presence of our loving God, let us take a moment of silence to ready ourselves for this celebration.
Lord, our God, creator of all life, of body and soul, we ask you to bless us with this water as we use it in faith. Embrace us with your unconditional love. Save us from all the illness and from the power of evil. Lord, in your mercy, give us living water, always springing up as a fountain of your love and mercy. Free us from every danger. Purify us so that we may live always in you. Grant this through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
We pray.
on our faith. O God, you graft us into Christ, the true vine. With tireless care, you nurture our growth in knowledge and reverence. Teach the vineyard of your church that in Christ each branch may bring fruit to the glory of your name, abundant fruits of faith and love. Complete our faith that one day we may live with you in that place which Christ prepares for us, where he lives with you now and always in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. As the number of disciples continued to grow, the Hellenists complained against the Hebrews because their widows were being neglected in the daily distribution. So the 12 called together the community of the disciples and said, "It is not right for us to neglect the word of God to serve at table. Brothers, select from among you 7 reputable men filled with the Holy Spirit and wisdom, whom we shall appoint to this task, whereas we shall devote ourselves to prayer and to the ministry of the word." The proposal was acceptable to the whole community, so they chose Stephen, a man filled with faith in the Holy Spirit, also Philip, Prochorus, Nicanor, Timon, Parmenas, and Nicholas of Antioch, a convert to Judaism. They presented these men to the apostles, who prayed and laid hands on them. The word of God continued to spread, and the number of the disciples in Jerusalem increased greatly. Even a large group of priests were becoming obedient to the faith. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Our trust in you.
A reading from the first letter of St. Peter. Beloved, come to him, a living stone rejected by human beings, but chosen and precious in the sight of God. And like living stones, let yourselves be built into a spiritual house, to be a holy priesthood, to offer spiritual sacrifices acceptable to God through Jesus Christ. For it says in Scripture, Behold, I am laying a stone in Zion, a cornerstone, chosen and precious, and whoever believes in it shall not be put to shame. Therefore, its value is for you who have faith, but for those without faith, the stone that the builders rejected has become the cornerstone, a stone that will make people stumble and a rock that will make them fall. They stumble by disobeying the word, as is their destiny. You are a chosen race, a royal priesthood, a holy nation, a people of his own, so that you may announce the praises of him who called you out of darkness into his wonderful light. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. And if I go to prepare a place for you, I will come back again and take you to myself. So, where I am, you also might be. Where I'm going, you do not know the way. Thomas says to him, Master, we do not know where you're going. How can we know the way? Jesus says to him, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me. If you know me, then you will also know my Father. From now on, you do know him and have seen him. Philip says to him, Master, show us the Father, and that will be enough for us. Jesus says to him, Have you been with you all for so long time? And you still do not know me, Philip? Whoever has seen the Father
knows, can you say, how can you say, show us the Father? Do you not believe that I am in the Father and the Father is in me? The words that I have spoken to you, I do not speak it on my own. The Father who dwells in me is doing the works. Believe me that I am in the Father and the Father is in me. Or else believe because of the works themselves. Amen, amen, I said to you, whoever believes in me will do the works that I do, and who will do and will do greater ones than this, because I am going to the Father. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
It is good that we are here in this space electronically. In fact, but most of all, that we are here together in spirit, brothers and sisters of one another, and daughters and sons of our Lord God. Particularly on a day like today, we listen to the scriptures and it speaks about the journey of faith that each and every one of us make throughout our lives, and is proclaimed today in particular ways. You may have heard the story about the college student who said to the professor in the religion class, "I don't believe in God anymore." And the professor replied, "Maybe I should congratulate you." And the student said, "Why? Maybe the God that you believe in is the wrong God." This is not something new to the student, to the college professor, the religion class. It's a journey that we all make throughout our lives, throughout history, wrestling with exactly who God is, this great mystery. We think we get an idea, an experience, and then something happens. Turns that upside down. It humbles us to take a longer look. Reading from the Acts of the Apostles that Linda read for us speaks about the Hellenists who were not so much a part of the culture of the Jewish people who were trying to follow Christ. They were more educated, came from different customs. But they experienced some discrimination, and it was the apostles who got the deacons who serve to help them, to include them, to make sure that their needs were attended to as well as the rest of the people. How about Philip? How often have we said in our own lives, "Show me, Lord, help me to experience your presence more fully." How often has that happened to each one of us when someone dies? We want to say, "Let me know you're okay, send me a sign." Philip's not seeing and believing what Jesus was saying about something pretty familiar to many of us. It's true in our own times, is it not? We may imagine God as one who tests our devotion or punishes our sinfulness, rather than believing in an author of unconditional love and eternal life. How much more that we can't even imagine. Is it not indeed challenging to follow the Good Shepherd who cares for all, no exception, and who guides us in a life of living for one another, not just for ourselves, even to the point of being willing to give one's life for another? On this day we celebrate Mother's Day. It is an example of love beyond measure, is it not? Something beyond what would be seemingly humanly possible. Mother's love for a child, though certainly challenged, does not diminish, no matter what. The profound inner joy of a mother who has given birth to a child, a mother who has embraced an infant, a toddler, as a daughter or son, is a bit of heaven here on earth. It is a love that knows no boundaries. And the anguish of a mother who loses a child to sickness or to violence is also beyond comprehension. The author John Shea writes, we dwell in essential mystery, which is the experience of the more that we know, the more mysterious it is. This may have been Jesus' challenge to Philip and to all of us. Do not let your hearts be troubled. Have faith in God. Have faith in me. As if to say, open your heart to my presence, to my absolute love. Come to know me better. Come to know God more fully. Trust me. And it is in this deeper faith, in this humbling trust, in this experience of the ongoing, never-ending presence of Christ in our lives, that we are able to announce the praises that Peter writes about, that we have a live faith that we have been given so that we might be a light to others, or that we might follow the light of others' faith as sons and daughters of God, others helping us through our own darkness. Say again, it is in this that smaller fears that normally terrorize us lose some of their power. They happen, oh yes indeed. But we are taken up into a larger truth that provides a meaning more in accord with love. On this Mother's Day, on this celebration of the Word and the Sacrament of the Eucharist, our gathering in spirit, let us remember and give thanks for the great love showered upon each and all of us, every day, all day. And so, friends, we have been buried with Christ in baptism so that we may rise with him to a new life. We now renew the promises that we were made for us and that we made in baptism as we turn away from sin, choosing to live a life worthy of Christ's calling. And so, do you reject sin so as to live in the freedom of God's children?
I do.
Do you reject the glamour of evil and refuse to be mastered by sin?
I do.
Do you reject Satan, the father of sin, the prince of darkness?
I do.
Do you believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth?
I do believe.
Do you believe in Jesus the Christ, God's only Son, our Lord, who was born of the Virgin Mary, was crucified, died, and was buried, who rose from the dead and is now seated at the right hand of God?
I do believe.
Do you believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, a communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and a life everlasting?
I do believe.
God, the all-powerful Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, has given us a new birth by water and by the Holy Spirit. The Lord has reconciled us. May God also keep us faithful to our Lord Jesus Christ. We pray forever and ever.
Amen.
Amen. God has made us a chosen race, a royal people, a priesthood set apart, and so we can pray for all those in need.
Our response today is, Risen Lord, hear our prayer. For the Holy Church, we seek to follow Christ so that we may show the whole world the way to the Father, we pray.
Risen Lord, hear our prayer.
For world leaders, that they might choose the path of peace over the ways of violence and conflict, we pray.
Risen Lord, hear our prayer.
For God's holy people gathered in their homes, that their words and actions may bear witness that Jesus is indeed the way, the truth, and the life, and invite others to follow him, we pray.
Risen Lord, hear our prayer.
For all our mothers on this special day, for our grandmothers, and all who have mothered and nurtured us in very many ways, we pray.
Risen Lord, hear our prayer.
For all frontline workers, that they may find strength and continue to serve those experiencing grief, depression, or despair during this difficult time, we pray.
Risen Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who are sick and are in need of healing and support, that they might find what they need in our community of faith, especially Amanda Alvarado and Tom Pingay. And for those who have asked our prayers and for those whom we now in full voice call out to our loving God.
Pat.
We pray, Risen Lord, hear our prayer. For our dearly departed, that they may be happy forever in the Father's house, which Jesus has prepared for them. We pray especially for all of our beloved mothers who have gone before us, but remain with us in spirit. And we pray especially for Jim Williams, the Maniola family, George and Dorothy Major, Joseph and Mary Wurtek, Philomena Blanca, Asuncion DeCampo, Ron Gummerson. And we pray for all who have died during this time of global crisis. We pray.
Risen Lord, hear our prayer.
And so, God of love, your only Son, Jesus the Christ, shows us the way that leads to you. Hear our prayers as priests, prophets, and kings, that we might spread the light of Christ to all we meet. We pray through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Thank you.
So pray, boys and girls, sisters and brothers in the Lord, that our offering, yours and mine, may be acceptable to our Lord God. May the Lord accept the sacrifice at our hands for the praise and glory of God's name, for our good and the good of all God's church. Lord of life, through the wonderful exchange of this offering, you have made us sharers in your own divine nature. May our daily lives be more faithfully reflective of the knowledge of your truth and presence and love. We pray through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
And the Lord is with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Together we give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
Lord, how powerful and ever living, we do well always and everywhere to give you thanks and praise through Jesus the Christ our Lord. We praise you with a great joy during this Easter season when Christ became our paschal sacrifice. He is the true Lamb who took away the sin of this world. By dying, he destroyed our death. By rising, he restored our life. And so with all the choirs of angels in heaven, we proclaim your glory, joining in their unending hymn of praise. Spirit upon them so that they may become for us the body and the blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus the Christ. The time that he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion and death, he took bread. Giving you thanks and praise, he blessed and broke the bread. Giving it to his disciples, he said to them, "Take this, all of you, and eat it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when the supper was ended, he took a cup of wine again, giving you thanks and praise. He gave the cup to his disciples and said to them, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the cup of my blood, the blood of the new and everlasting covenant. It will be shed for you and for all, so that sins may be forgiven. Do this in memory of me."
The mystery of our faith.
Salvation. We give thanks that you hold us worthy to live in your presence and to serve you by serving and by loving one another. Humbly we pray, Lord, that partaking in the body and the blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by your Holy Spirit. Remember your people spread throughout this world. Bring all of us the fullness of charity together with Francis, our Pope, with Blaise, our Bishop, with all of your people. Remember all of our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, all who have died in your mercy and love. Welcome them into the light of your presence. Lord, have mercy on all of us. We pray that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, and all of the apostles and saints, we who have pleased you throughout the ages may come to be co-heirs to the eternal life and praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus the Christ. Through him, with him, and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever. Our Father,
who art in
heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread,
and
forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us.
And
lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, from every evil. Grant us peace in our day. In your love and mercy, keep us free from sin, protect us from all anxiety, as we wait in joyful hope for the coming of our Savior, Jesus the Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory of God is now and forever.
May the peace of the Lord be with all of you.
And with your spirit.
I fall on my knees to the floor.
the spring. Lord, you remain close to all of us, your daughters and sons. You have enriched us with these heavenly mysteries. Grant that we may pass from our former ways into this new life in the risen Christ more fully each and every day. We pray through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
We have a special Mother's Day blessing for all you moms at home. Family members, please gather around, hold your hands, extend your hands over your moms, grandmas, for this blessing, and the Church of the Holy Spirit family sends its prayer of blessings as well. Loving God, as a mother gives life and nourishment to her children, so you watch over your people, your church. Bless these women that they may be strengthened as Christian mothers. Let the example of their faith and love shine forth. Grant that we, their daughters and sons, may honor them always with the spirit of profound respect. Grant this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Amen. And the Lord is with you.
And with your spirit.
May the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit descend upon you and be with you always. Amen.
Brothers and sisters, this holy celebration of today's Mass has ended. Please go in peace and try to love one another.
Thanks be to God.